firstly, one of the most interesting stories that happened recently was in Los Angeles with a Mr. Joe Moshe, M-O-S-H-E, which people can Google and find themselves. On Thursday, he was surrounded by a SWAT team after he had called in last week to Dr. Truat's show on Republic Broadcasting and called in asking if there was a state's attorney or someone he could give evidence to because he was apparently a biological scientist with a dual citizenship in Israel. And he had evidence that the Baxter in had a Ukraine lab actually not making a vaccine but making a bioweapon that was going to cause a plague when the vaccine was released. Now, of course, True didn't believe him at first, but what happened is immediately after the next day, a SWAT team, literally an army, surrounded his Volkswagen Beetle in West Los Angeles. They hit his car four times with pepper cannons, and then they sent in a robot after they he just sat in the car, and apparently they were surprised that he didn't kind of cough and choke and come out. They sent in a robot to break a back window, and they tasered him and hauled him out through the windows. They tried to claim in the news article he threatened the president, Obama, and he didn't do anything of the sort. What he did, actually, is he called in and said, I have new information because I'm a biological scientist that they are planning on releasing the Baxter vaccine made in the Ukraine that will be shipped to America, and it will, because it's one of the primary contracts, and it's going to contain lethal genes that will cause the death of millions. We're sitting on a powder keg here where we not only have the returning virus that's tracking along 1918 swine flu, which is going to be much more lethal than the 1957 flu that killed 75,000. The 1918 flu killed around 675,000 Americans. Worldwide probably killed between 40 and 100 million because in third world countries it was much more lethal. This virus is probably going to be as lethal as this in the second and third waves. And if it ever acquires the H5N1 genes, it'll probably have a lethality of somewhere around 70%. So we're looking at a world nation killer and something that in the next several years could get increasingly lethal, causing a shutdown of international commerce. The government wants this. They're actually doing everything they can to do all the wrong measures, and they're approving vaccines that are almost certainly going to make the virus evolve even quicker. So this has the ring of truth. There's something going on here where we have whistleblowers coming out that are basically telling us, hey, they are going to release a, they're not just satisfied with the virus mutating and recombining, either becoming less or more lethal. They want to tweak it along to make sure that it's lethal enough they can declare martial law, which is what the government's pushing for.
And Baxter, a vaccine company, was caught red-handed contaminating vaccine material with live bird flu virus. Well, the key evidence, at least here in Austria, is that Baxter's facilities in Olten, the Donau, are obliged to follow Biosafety Regulation 3. So it's kind of like Fort Knox. You have to imagine getting 72,000 gold bars out of Fort Knox by accident. And you can see that just doesn't happen. And in the same way, you can't just get 72 kilos of live bird flu virus contaminated vaccine material out of a biosafety level 3 laboratory unless it's intentional.
I was also taken to a place in Youngstown, Ohio, that was referred to as Charm School. And it was at Charm School where I endured the usual sleep, food, and water deprivation and trauma, and then sex slave programming. This sex slave programming was to program me for different sexual acts that were carried out with various politicians who thought that their perversions would never be revealed. They were wrong. It's all detailed in our book, Transformation of America. I was also programmed to carry out specific sexual perversions in Bohemian Grove. Bohemian Grove in Northern California is a political playground and a place where some business is discussed despite what they say. The business that's discussed is discussed in a little place called The Underground. And that underground is spelled with a capital U and a capital N. Underground. It was there I heard George Bush talking about mass genocide. What the plans were for mind control. And it was a Bohemian Grove that my daughter and I were subjected to brutal perversions, all of which were being covertly filmed. These covert films were then used for blackmail purposes because these criminals didn't trust each other. And they all had some bad information on the other one that they kept so that they could keep each other under control. In 1983, Senator Byrd acted in the capacity of a pimp and prostituted me to then-President Ronald Reagan. It was also in Lampy, Missouri that I saw Bill Clinton and George Bush together. In 1984, they were there to carry out certain perversions as well as indulge in what they refer to as the most dangerous game. It's their favorite sport of hunting humans. It's taken from a military operation where a person fights for their life and runs for their life in an attempt to escape being hunted. My daughter and I both endured being hunted by George Bush, and he's often said that it was his...